something from Scripture this evening, and here I am to share that. Centenary is always a great occasion, isn't it? It's a wonderful occasion to share. You're very fortunate to be in this band at this moment in its history. A centenary. You share this year with the Battle of George Square in Glasgow, when workers accepted that the norm for the working week would be 47 hours. You share this week with this year centenary with the first non-stop flight across the Atlantic by Alcock and Brown. You share this centenary with the Treaty of Versailles, which officially brought to end the First World War, and of course the first 2 minute silence. You also share this centenary with the occasion on which the very first female Labour MP took her seat, and Lady Astor, the MP for Plymouth Sutton, took her seat in Parliament. Centenary. What a wonderful occasion. As you said, reminded us, on the 28th of May 1919, had me thinking for a moment, it was decided, the railwaymen decided that they would form a band. On the 1st of July, they called a meeting and they decided that they would send people to Shrewsbury Test to view a set of 24 instruments. At the next meeting, there were 47 people present to play these 24 instruments. How they coped, I don't know. But what I do know is that if it happened that quickly, then British Railways moves a whole lot quicker then. You know? No, I didn't say that. But you've had a great history. You've had a great history. And it's great to share it this evening this way, in a church, in a building that is dedicated to the glory of God, because music is a gift from God. God could have made the world without music. Just think about that. He could have made the world without music. And yet he didn't. He chose to give us music. What a feast we've enjoyed this evening, haven't we? What a feast we've enjoyed this evening. And by doing this, we share something of our praise of God. Music, everybody likes some sort of music. Not everybody likes every sort of music. And I have to tell you that not everybody likes brass bands. The great Sir Thomas Beecham on one occasion said, "I find brass bands have a melancholy sound. All right out of doors, 50 miles away, like bagpipes, they turn what had been a dream into a public nuisance." Okay, that was Sir Thomas Beecham. Other people have had different ideas, but other people have had different ideas about music in general. Sir Elton John can say, "Music has healing power. It has the ability to take people out of themselves for a while." Or Plato, "Music is a moral law. It gives soul to the universe, wings to the mind, flight to the imagination, and charm and gaiety to life and everything." Lady Gaga, you'd expect me to quote Lady Gaga from my book. Lady Gaga says, "Music is one of the most powerful things the world has to offer." Sorry, "Music is one of the most powerful things the world has to offer. It has the power to unite us." And my friends this evening, that's an enormous power that you wield. That's an enormous power in these days that music wields. If we can unite the world, then indeed we give praise and glory to God. A great evening, great music, both brass music and the vocal music. Great evenings. always giving thanks to God through Christ Jesus, our Lord. And the psalmist, of course, said, praise God, praise God. Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him for his surpassing greatness. Praise him with the sounding of the trumpet. Praise him with the harp and the lyre. Praise him with timbrel and dancing. Praise him with strings and pipe. Praise him with the clash of cymbals. And we've had the clash of cymbals tonight. Praise him with resounding cymbals.